This statement is very true when it comes to video editing, especially if you're a professional relying on it for a living. Even if it's just a hobby, the less time you spend editing, the more time you get out and film, helping you tell a better story. The trick is to speed up your editing without giving up any quality, and today we'll take a look at 3 things you can do to speed up your editing process in Final Cut Pro. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. In this video, we'll take a look at how you can speed up your editing workflow without giving up any quality in your finished product. Let's not waste any more time and take a look at 3 things you can do to speed up your editing workflow. First up is keyboard shortcuts. Taking the time to learn these and using keyboard shortcuts can be a huge time saver. For example, in Final Cut Pro, to create a new project, you have to go to the menu bar and select File, New, and Project. This can be done much faster by simply pressing Command N. It may not seem like you're saving much time here, but a fraction of a second here, half a second there, can really add up, especially when you use these for repetitive tasks. For example, when you need to make a cut in your video clip, you have to click on the tool drop-down menu, select the blade tool, skim your clip to the frame where you want to make a cut, click on the clip to blade it, go back to the drop-down menu, and choose the select tool again. If you're using keyboard shortcuts, all you have to do is place your skimmer on the selected frame and press Command B. Your clip is now bladed into 2 and you're back to using the select tool, much quicker. If you want to zoom in on your timeline for more precision, you have to open up the clip appearance menu and use a slider to zoom in and out on your timeline. This can be done much quicker by using keyboard shortcuts. Command and equal sign to zoom in on your timeline, or Command and minus sign to zoom out. You can also press Shift-Z to fit your entire timeline to your window. This is just a few examples, but there are a ton of keyboard shortcuts in Final Cut Pro, and learning to use just a few of these can save you a lot of time. To see the available keyboard shortcuts, head up to the menu bar, click on Final Cut Pro, select Commands, and Customize, or use the keyboard shortcut Option Command K. Here, you can see all the actions that have keyboard shortcuts assigned to them, or even customize them to make your own. If you want to know my top keyboard shortcuts I use, I'll link my top 15 keyboard shortcuts up here and in the video description below. Number 2 on my list is custom effect presets. You can take a number of steps you do regularly and save them as a custom effect preset. For example, when making tutorial videos for the finished effect, I like to zoom in on the viewer in my screen recording. If I simply scaled up my clip, I would lose a lot of resolution and it would look like crap. So what I do is I take the original video I use in my tutorial and add it as a connected clip above my screen recording. Next, I scale down and reposition my connected clip until it lines up perfectly with the clip in my viewer. With the playhead at the start of the clip, I'll add a keyframe to the transform parameter. Next, for a nice smooth zoom effect, I move my playhead ahead about 10 to 15 frames, bring the scale back to 100%, set the X and the Y position values to 0, and change my keyframes from smooth to linear. All these steps combined give me this nice viewer zoom effect. I do this quite often in my videos, and as you can see, it takes a bit of time. To save time, I can take all these steps I repeat in almost all of my videos and save it as a custom effect preset. Select your clip you applied your effects to, and right under the inspector window, click the Save Effects Preset button. In the pop-up window, select all the applied parameters you want to save in your preset. For my example, all the transform parameters I changed are selected, and since I color graded my clip, color wheels are also selected. The color corrections are unique to this clip, so I'll deselect the color wheels checkbox. Also, if you keyframed any parameters, you can either maintain the timing of your keyframes or stretch them to fit the clip you apply this to. Select the category you want to save your preset in, give it a name, and click Save. Next time you need to do the same effect, open your effects browser, select the category you saved your preset in, and simply drag and drop your saved preset onto your clip. All the steps taken in the previous clip will be applied to the clip you're on. This can be used for pretty much every effect or parameter included in Final Cut Pro, and as you can see, it's a huge time saver. Last on my list is Optimized or Proxy Media. Most cameras today record in either H.264 or H.265 codecs. These are great and allow a ton of information to be recorded to your video, but unfortunately, they're not very editor friendly. This is because videos recorded in these codecs are highly compressed to allow the maximum amount of information to be recorded in the smallest amount of space. When you edit the videos recorded in these codecs, Final Cut Pro has to decompress your clips as you edit. Now, Final Cut Pro is very efficient at this, but it does take a lot of system resources, especially when you're editing higher resolution videos. Creating Optimizer Proxy Media converts your video files to a much more editor-friendly ProRes 422 codec. These files work much better with Final Cut Pro and can save you a lot of time when editing. There are two ways to transcode your media to ProRes 422. One is when you import your files in the Import window on the right-hand side. You can choose to create optimized media or create proxy media. Neither one of these will affect the quality of your export, just the way they appear in Final Cut Pro. Optimized media retains the resolution and the frame rate of your original clip, but the file sizes can be huge. Proxy media files, on the other hand, are medium quality, about half the original resolution, with a low data rate. These file sizes are considerably smaller, so if hard drive space is an issue, or you're using an older machine to edit, proxy files may give you the best performance. The second way of transcoding your video files is by selecting your clip in the media browser, and from the menu bar select File, Transcode Media, and either Optimized Media, Proxy Media, or both. After your media has been transcoded, you can switch between the two in the Viewer drop-down menu. Just remember, if using proxy media files to edit, make sure to switch back to original or optimized files before your export. If you don't, you'll export your project with proxy files with reduced video resolution. These are my three tips to speed up your editing process in Final Cut Pro. I want to hear in the comments below the steps you take to speed up your editing process. I look forward to hearing all your tips and tricks, and I'm always open to learning something new. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button, and if you haven't yet, please subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.